Very good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the session. BA History Program, Second Semester, Session Number 19. I am Sudhaji, Assistant Professor, Department of History, GFGC, Rippanpet. You can notice on the screen some of the great personalities such as Kabir, Guru Nanak, Tulasidas, Mirabai, Surdas, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Can you guess the movement to which they belong to in medieval India? Yes, your answer is right. It's Bhakthi movement. Today, in this session, let us explore the causes for the rise of Bhakthi movement. Students knew that the concept of Bhakthi cult can be traced back to the Vedic age. They have also learned about turmoils created by the Muslim invaders in India. They are aware of the pathetic condition of Hindus who wanted a kind of solace. Learning objectives of today's session: to enable the students to know the meaning of Bhakthi movement, to make them to understand the causes for the rise of Bhakthi movement, to introduce the exponents of Bhakthi movement. Learning outcomes: at the end of the session, students will feel soothing experience of Bhakthi. Students will appreciate the initiative taken by the exponents of Bhakthi movement to protect the Indians from the turmoils of Muslim rulers. They will also identify personalities like Kabir Das, Guru Nanak, Mirabai, Tulasidas, Surdas, etc. They will compare medieval India's conditions with modern India. To begin with, Bhakthi movement emphasized an intense devotion to God during medieval India. It was a revolution started by the Hindu saints to bring religious reforms by adopting the methods of devotions to achieve salvation. The wave of Bhakthi movement started from South India by Alvars and Nayanmars, the devotees of Lord Vishnu and Shiva respectively. It is an important landmark in the cultural history of medieval India, a silent revolution in society brought about by a galaxy of socio-religious reformers, a revolution known as the Bhakthi movement. It started in the 8th century by Shankaracharya, which continued up to 16th century by a number of Hindu devotees, preachers, and religious reformers. Shankaracharya is called Jagadguru, the teacher of the whole universe. Do you know one more person who is called Jagadguru? Yes, it's Lord Shri Krishna. Vasudeva Sutam Devam Kamsa Chanura Mardhanam Devaki Paramanandam Krishnam Vande Jagadgurum. During the Bhakthi movement, we witness many devotees, preachers, and religious reformers. Just now you have seen on the screen Kabir Das, Nanak, Meera, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Tulsidas, Surdas, etc. Now let us move to know the causes for the rise of Bhakthi movement. Attempts of fanatic Muslim rulers, that is Dharmanda Muslim rulers, to enforce Islam and its laws on Hindus. Hindus had suffered materially, morally, and spiritually under them. The Hindu society was full of social anomalies. It means peculiar practices of the Hindu society. Bhakti movement was an intense devotion to God. Bhakti to God was accepted as a means to achieve salvation. There are four purusharthas: dharma, artha, kama, and moksha. Liberation is the ultimate aim of human life. It's possible to attain moksha or salvation only through bhakti. The rigid caste system, the complicated ritualisms that constituted the practice of worship, and the inherent need to a more fulfilling method of worship and salvation perhaps spurred this movement. As a social movement, Bhakti movement everywhere in India challenged caste hierarchy, emphasized the individual's direct connections to God, and the possibility of moksha for all through good deeds and simple living. It was an Indian's response to face a new challenge that appeared in the form of Islamic religion. It is the direct outcome of the emergence of Islam in India. In addition to this, irrelevant rituals and religious practices, blind faiths and social dogmas, which I told you. Social dogmas means doctrine of belief in a religion. Besides all this, polytheism was also in practice. Polytheism means Bahudevata Aradhane, worshipping of many gods. Segregation, setting someone apart from others. That is, economic disparities led to caste system and untouchability. Find out the article of Indian Constitution in which practice of untouchability is an offense, a punishable crime. It is an assignment for you. Hinduism was monopolized by the Brahmins. Indian society was classified into four categories: Brahmin, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas, and Shudras. Brahmins, being educated, they occupied the first category. They got government posts also, hence they used to dominate the society. Brahmins themselves led a degenerated and corrupt moral life. Common men in general had developed an adverse attitude towards them. They were in need of a liberal form of religion. Popular dissatisfaction against socio-religious evils is also one among the causes for the rise of Bhakti movement. Besides all these reasons, an absolute need to bring radical changes in Hindu beliefs, to liberate Hindus from the monopoly and injustice of the priestly classes, common people preferred more simple religious practices and simple social customs than rigid Vedic rituals. Influence of Sufi saints who emphasized on love and devotion, which brought harmony between Hindu Muslims. Bhakti movement witnessed the emergence of saints and reformers who tried to purge Hinduism of its evils and blind practices. The chief exponents of Bhakti movements were Kabir Das, Guru Nanak, Mirabai, Ramananda, Tulasi Das, Sur Das, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Namadev, Tukaram, Vallabhacharya, Madhava, and Chandidas, etc. Before moving to conclusion, I would like to spread an aroma of bhakti so that all of you can get blessings of Almighty. Let us enjoy the devotional songs together. Thank you.
सुंदर रूप याचे देव वक्र तुंड देव लंबोदर देव वक्र तुंड देव लंबोदर
Let us summarize the session. Bhakti movement was a reply to Islam monotheism and egalitarianism by way a new interpretation of Hinduism. This movement is one of the revivalist movements in Hinduism which took place in medieval India. Before winding the session, let us have a quick recapitulation of the main points what we have learned today. The socio-religious conditions of medieval India, the need to bring radical changes in the medieval Indian society, the saints and reformers of Bhakti movement, influence of Sufi saints on Hinduism. The books which I have referred to prepare my talk are Medieval India by Satish Chandra, Medieval History of India by J.C. Agarwal, and Bhakti Movement History Discussion.net. I hope you would have enjoyed my session. Thank you so much.